Now, first guest, Xolani Jwaga, first captured the hearts of gospel enthusiasts nationwide during his live recordings of his debut album, Hosanna, which is still on high rotation on radio and on television shows. Now, his current single, Belokheman, has also created quite a huge buzz after it debuted at number 3 on digital download platforms. Let's have a look at one of his stellar performances.
Sensational energy, Xolani. Welcome to Afternoon Express. Thank you so much for being on here with
Thank
us this
so
Easter
much.
Monday.
Thank you so much for
So I maintain that the best people in South Africa come from the East Rand. What was your life growing up in, what was it like growing up in Xolani?
Growing up.
You're from Kwa-Thema?
Yeah, Kwa-Thema.
Okay.
I'm from Kwa-Thema Springs.
Yeah.
The east of Joburg. I grew up raised by my grandparents,
yeah,
who were pastors, you know. But I had nothing to do. I didn't want to do anything with church.
Really?
You know, I'd wake
up. Were you a little rebel?
Yeah. You'd say that because I would wake up every morning, 6 o'clock, and run away.
Yeah.
Every Sunday, actually. Every Sunday, 6 o'clock, I run away because church was home.
Yeah.
So if I don't go, then I have to go to church.
Exactly. You know?
So I'd come back late afternoon.
Where would you run away to?
I'd go to friends. And being raised by grandparents,
yeah,
you get away with a lot of things, you know. And they've got soft spots, and when you come back, they're like, "No, why did you do that?" "No, I wanted to go play," you know.
Yeah.
And I grew up there. I grew up, of course, prayer pressure was there, and I experienced a lot of things, substance abuse.
Really?
I tried everything.
At what age?
12 years.
No
years
ways.
Old. Yes. It's the scar you see, it's a scar, it's not a birthmark.
Yeah.
Because we were smoking weed.
Yeah.
And the guy, when we were drunk, and he started hitting the fire.
Yeah.
And it came straight to my eye. You
wow.
know? But as I grow up, it goes down. I guess when I'm 50 to be here, you know?
Well, that's amazing.
Yeah, so...
That could have ended very badly, actually.
Yes, yes.
Was that the point in your life where you thought, oh, I'm not going to touch drugs again, and I'm going to...
No.
He still carried on partying.
I continued. The last incident, actually... It was when a friend of mine took a gun from his uncle, who was a policeman, and gave it to me. And I took the gun home, and then they came. They said they were looking for a gun. I said, I don't have a gun. So they said, okay, let's call the police so that they search your house. Then that was my day. Like,
but what were you going to do with the gun?
I don't know. What I knew is that it's a gun, and if I've got the gun, then I'm protected and all those things.
Wow. Well, so your situation was obviously quite dark.
Yes.
Do you think it's the case of, you know, you always hear that a minister's child always rebels,
yeah.
I suppose, because there's kind of pressure on you to behave in a certain way and kind of be holier than everybody else and be, you know, more outstanding than everyone else in all of your achievements. So do you think you felt that pressure and that led you down a dark road?
Not really, not even, because, you know, growing up in a location where boys are there and you want to try out something, everyone says, oh, try this,
yeah.
You know, and, you know, you just want to experience things and explore more than anything. And you know you can get away with that, you know. So it was just that.
So what was the moment in your life when you then re-fell in love with God, I suppose, chose a righteous path, and then found gospel?
Okay, my grandfather passed on in 1998. And after he passed on, my grandmother said, I can't handle him. They sent me to her daughter, which is Togo Mabena, and I started going to church. I was forced to go to church because everyone is going to church. They participate in. But I was fascinated by drums. I wanted to play drums so much. Mm. And there was a guy who said, you can't play drums if you're not saved. I said, keep your salvation and then I'm out. But there was a pastor who preached, I think it was November,
yeah.
Pastor, the late Pastor Peche, and my life, I just found myself crying and I said, I accept the Lord Jesus. And that was the turning point. And I was a slow learner, you know,
yeah.
Very slow at school. I failed at primary school 6 times. And you know, wow. You have to be at primary school for 7 years.
Yeah.
So if it's 6 plus 7,
yeah.
So that's 11 years. So, but my turning point, when I accepted Jesus, everything changed.
Really?
You know, I was an A student. You can go to my university because I never thought I'll get there.
Yeah.
You know, when I was in university, my fail was a 98%.
Wow.
That was my fail.
Wow. I suppose there's so much to be said for allowing so much beauty and positive energy and love into your life,
mm-hmm.
and allowing yourself to feel better.
Yes.
And
yes.
Just more.
Yeah, that's true.
So, and now you're outselling all of your shows and doing so well. What do you think it is about your sound and I suppose your vocal ministry,
yes.
that keeps on bringing people back to watch you?
Nothing else, but it's a mystery. It's what God does, and when He gives a person, He gives us differently. You know, one thing that I know, that I always minister and people come with testimonies.
Yeah.
I was sick and I got healed.
Yeah.
My marriage was broken. You happened. You know, 2 days ago, I got a woman who came to me after my performance, said I was about to divorce and my husband agreed, but I want to call my husband now. And immediately,
wow.
She called. Guess what? After the show, the husband was there to pick her up. They sent me a long inbox to say thank you, this is what has happened, you know.
Wow.
So I always get testimonies every yeah. time I minister.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think beautiful things happen when you spread love.
Yes, yes.
Thank
yes.
you so much for being here today. We cannot wait for your performance a
thank
little
you
bit
so
later.
Much. Thank you so
and I'm
much
obsessed with your shoes.
Thank you.